Good morning, everyone, and welcome to Hana Family Worship on this kind of a chilly Sunday morning. It definitely feels like fall. Believe it or not, Halloween is coming up in 7 days or so. I believe it's coming Saturday, Halloween Day. There's no trick or treating allowed in LA. A lot of parties and programs are canceled. So I don't know what you have in plan for Halloween, but hopefully you can spend it meaningfully and in some fun way with your family and friends. Well, talking about something fun, these people thought building a tower, tall tower was fun because they wanted to make a name for themselves. And this was sort of a way they challenged God. People wanted to build a tall tower that reaches to heaven, and they wanted to make a name for themselves, and they wanted to challenge God that way. Now, our Bible trivia question is, what was the name of that tower? What was the name of the tower that people built so tall, reaching the sky to challenge God? Raise your hand for the right answer. Was it number one, Kadesh? Was it number two, Babylon? Was it number three, Babel? Was it number four, Calvary? Well, most of you today blocked your screen today, so I'm not being able to see your hands, but I trust your judgment, and I'm sure you have the right answer. And it is Babel, right? Babel. It's like babbling. God confused people's language so they cannot communicate to build a tower to challenge God. So God had a solution to stop people making that tower to challenge God. And the lesson for that is we have to honor God within his system. We have to be obedient than other than becoming competitive or challenging God in any possible way. If we do challenge God, who is the creator and almighty, he will stop us within his own way. So that was the lesson from the Tower of Babel. Do not compete with God. Do not challenge God. Every Sunday, 11 o'clock, we gather here to worship our God. Once again, singing the song of worship is one of the most important elements of our Sunday worship. So to signify that, every time you hear the word or see the word worship within this praise song, gently raise your left hand, and this will be our symbol of honoring God, worshiping God, okay? So the key word today is worship. If you hear it, if you see it on the screen, raise your left hand.
Majesty!
He's the King. He's the King.
Let us take a moment to pray. And today we're going to pray for our neighbors, friends, relatives, family members who might need our help, our prayers. You know, this pandemic is causing a lot of people to get sick, struggling in their financial situations. And even if those who are not physically sick or financially struggling, a lot of people having a hard time emotionally. So if you look around, you know, you're among your friends, your relatives, there should be someone who might need your help. And this is time to do good deeds. And good deeds is the way we express Jesus' love in our actions. You cannot do good deeds with words only. You cannot do good deeds with prayers only. We need the heart, we need the prayers, but it must continue on in connection with action. So good deeds is about doing something good for our friends and neighbors. As we take this time to say the prayer of intercession, think about those friends or relatives, your neighbors who might need your help, and think about how you can help him or her in some practical ways. Let us take a moment to pray.
The Miracle of Mercy, the Good Samaritan. This is Jesus, who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. You see, when Jesus was on earth, he wanted everyone to know what God thought about things. So he took every opportunity to teach people about God's heart. One day, a religious expert stood up to test Jesus by asking him this question: "Teacher, what should I do to inherit eternal life?" "What does the law say?" The man answered, "You must love the Lord your God with all your heart, all your soul, all your strength, and all your mind, and love your neighbor as yourself." "Right.
All right.
Do this and you will live."
"Wait."
The man then asked, "And who is my neighbor?" Jesus replied with a story. A Jewish man was traveling from Jerusalem down to Jericho, and he was attacked by bandits. They stripped him of his clothes, beat him up, and left him half dead beside the road. By chance, a priest came along. But when he saw the man lying there, he crossed to the other side of the road and passed him by. Another man who worked in the temple, who was called a Levite, walked over and looked at him lying there.
He's out.
But he also passed by on the other side. Then a Samaritan came along. Samaritans were hated by Jews. They were seen as lesser people, and Jews would not interact with them. But when the Samaritan saw the man, he felt compassion for him. Going over to him, the Samaritan soothed his wounds with olive oil and wine and bandaged them. Then he put the man on his donkey and took him to an inn, where he took care of him.
One room, please.
The next day, he handed the innkeeper 2 silver coins, telling him, "Take care of this man. If his bill runs higher than this, I'll pay you the next time I'm here." Now, which of these 3 would you say was a neighbor to the man who was attacked by bandits? The man replied, "The one who showed him mercy." Then Jesus said, "Yes, now go and do the same."
So these people wanted to have eternal life. They wanted to have salvation. So they asked Jesus, "How can we have eternal life? How can we be saved?" Jesus said, "You should know. You know the law. What does the law say?" Probably these people cited what they memorized. Love the Lord your God with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your strength, all your mind. And love your neighbor as yourself. We know this, so we just have to keep this, right? Jesus says, "That's right. You have to do it. You have to do it." Many people know how to love God. Many people know how to love people, neighbors, friends. Problem is just, they just don't do it. They know it, but they don't do it. That's the problem. So the lesson of Good Samaritan is all about doing. It's all about doing. If you think about Christianity, it's all about doing. You know, that's the difference between, let's say, Buddhism and Christianity. I'm just picking up one religion as an example. Buddhism is all about thinking. Buddhism is all about meditating. Buddhism is all about understanding life and very little focus on doing. There are many religions like that in this world. A lot of religions talk about thinking, meditating, understanding, you know, that's all about self-awareness, enlightenment. But Christianity, what the Bible says about loving God, loving neighbors, is all about doing. So faith is about action. To love God, we need to love our neighbors. To love our neighbors, we have to do certain things, just like the Good Samaritan. Number one, it costs money. It costs money. So Good Samaritan saw this person who was dying on the street. And immediately What he did was he poured oil and wine, expensive. You know, oil and wine back then, we're talking about 2,000 years ago, it was very expensive. I mean, even today, if you want to buy fine oil, good wine, it costs a lot of money. I mean, we don't know exactly how much money, how much money it was worth, the oil and wine the Samaritan had. But it was really precious and expensive. But he poured it on the scars of this person dying on the street. Not only that, Samaritan took this dying person to an inn overnight, stayed with him, but he had to go on a business meeting the next morning. But when he was leaving, he promised the innkeeper, I'm going to come back and I'll pay you more. Here, I give you $200 right now, but I promise you, if it costs more than that, I'm going to come back and make sure my friend is being taken care of. All the medications and food and whatever you need to take care of him, please, please do so. I'll come back, I'll pay you. You see, caring for people, we have to make monetary sacrifice. And we have to do it fully until that person fully recovers. Oftentimes, we make little donations if there's some earthquake, if there's fire damage, if there's some floods, some people lost their homes, and, you know, we just make little donation, like $10, $20, which is good. I'm not saying that's bad. Because a lot of people in this world don't even do that. They don't even care. So if you make that kind of donations to the people in tragedy, people who were struck by some disasters, it's really good. But we have to think about not one-time little donation to help them, but we have to think about what kind of ultimate sacrifice we can make that we can really help them until they get up on their feet. It costs money to be a good Samaritan. It takes time. Everybody's busy. You know, the priest who just passed by, probably his excuse was, I'm too busy. I have to go to the temple and I have to lead sacrifice. I'm too busy to stop and care for this person. I'm sorry, but I'm too busy. The Levite who also passed by was probably thinking the same thing. Oh, I have to go and I have a bunch of work to do. I really wish I had some time to take care of this poor guy, but hopefully some other person who has more time than me will come and take care of him. So the priest who passed by was too busy. The Levite who passed by was too busy. And you don't think the Samaritan was busy? Of course he was busy too. He probably had to make some business transactions and he was busy too. But he knew what was more important than his business and things he had to do. You look at today's world, everybody is just too busy to do good deeds. Everybody is just too busy. I have to study, I have to play, I have to work, I have these schedules, I have to meet all these people. They have a bunch of other reasons or excuses. And in that midst of busyness, they lose something really, really important, and that is to care for those who are in need. It takes time to be a good Samaritan. We have to make time in that hectic schedule of ours to be good Samaritan. So if you know anyone who might need your help, they need your prayer, they need your, you know, counseling or friendship, you know, you have to start thinking about how can I make some time for that person because that will be the first step. You need to stop. You need to pause. You need to make time for that person so you can help. It takes time to be a good Samaritan. And you have to take some risk. So we're talking about bandits. You know, these bandits who attacked this poor guy. The Bible says bandits in plural. There was more than one person who attacked him. And because this was kind of an open road, they might be still there in nearby hiding place. So by helping this poor guy, this good Samaritan put himself in that risk of being discovered, and maybe bandits come back and attack the Samaritan guy too. So there was that risk. I mean, we need to be wise. We need to be cautious. We need to make sure we find some safe ways to help other people. But in certain situations, we got to take some of that risk to help other people. It's just a lot of people today don't want to go that far. Okay, I'm going to give little money. Okay, I'm going to do little like Zoom talk with our friends. But in terms of making myself available in that inconvenience or in that risk, I'm not going to do it. As long as it's convenient, as long as it's safe, I will help. But not more than that, but not further than that. You draw the line there. But, you know, the Bible is teaching us it has to be practical help, not only money, not only time, but we have to make that sacrifice of being exposed to risk. God will protect us and God will give us wisdom to overcome those difficult situations, dangerous situations. But we have to be willing to take that risk to help other people and share Jesus' love. And Good Samaritan did that. In some practical ways, he helped the poor guy dying on the street. Now, chances are, we're not going to find some people dying on the street or in front of our doorstep that we have to run out and then save. I mean, it might happen, but then chances are not very high that we're going to run into that kind of situation. But we'll probably find many friends of ours who might need our help, just little things, but important things. Maybe all they need is just a little talk. Maybe all they need is just like $10, $20, so they need to buy whatever they need for school or some very important things. But within our limitation, we need to be willing to spend our money, time, and being at risk to practically help our friends and neighbors. Love is all about doing. Faith is all about doing. So upon this, we're going to take a moment to meditate and pray. Christianity is all about loving God, loving neighbors. And it's about action. It's about doing something for God, doing something for our neighbors. Maybe we have been just too passive. Maybe we have been playing it a little bit too safe. Do we spend our time and money for God and our neighbors? Am I willing to put myself in that risk, trusting God's protection, to help those who are in need? Am I brave enough to put myself in the position of Good Samaritan? Think about that. Take a moment to pray. Father God, we thank you for your lesson today. Now we have to confess that all this time we believed in you with our thinking only. We pray that we love you by words only. We did give our little help to our friends and neighbors, but it was kind of spontaneous and it was just momentary, just one time thing. It didn't last and we didn't stick to it. We didn't do all the follow-ups until the end. Father God, as this good Samaritan took care of this poor person dying on the street, help us to express Jesus' love in our actions. Help us to do something for you, not only worship on Sunday, not only say prayers a couple of times a week, but help us to live day by day, moment by moment, within your will, as the confession of our love for you. And for our neighbors and friends, help us to find some practical ways that we can spend our time and money for their own good. And help us to be willing to be in that shoe, be in that same position as they are, so we can truly share Jesus' love in the common ground. Father God, help us to be like Good Samaritan who shares Jesus' love to the people who are in need. We thank you for your lesson and grace. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.